Hello, my friends, and welcome back to the Long Dark. On this, our Interloper playthrough, this is episode 53. We are currently in the maintenance shed here at the Broken Railroad. Let's go ahead and get a drink. And guys, we have done it. We have officially survived 100 days in the Long Dark. Last night, we went to sleep and completed 100 days. And now we've woken up on day 101. And as far as I'm concerned, we're living on borrowed time now. I never thought I'd get to a day 100. And, you know, I can't even speculate how long we'll last. I'm going to do my best to keep Astrid alive. Wow, day 100. That is amazing. Okay, so last night in our in the previous episode, we did catch a ptarmigan. And I don't want to carry the ptarmigan with me because he or she is going to be smelly. What a beautiful bird, though. Absolutely beautiful. So what I think I need to do before we head out is we probably need to harvest up the feathers. Because I think if I don't harvest the feathers, it's going to despawn. Like, the condition is just going to, go down. Unfortunately, it takes a really long time. An hour and 52 minutes. Looks like we could use our hand, I guess, just plucking feathers. And you know, somebody made a comment. I was complaining about how long it took to pluck these feathers, and they were absolutely right. They said, you know how long it takes to pluck feathers on a real bird? It does take a long time. One thing I learned, though, I lived in South Africa for a while, and I remember this native lady I lived with, a Zulu lady, she would actually use boiling water. I think that might be pretty common. They use boiling water on the skin of the bird. I think it does help to loosen up their hold on the feathers, make it easier to pluck. So it'd be interesting if the game had the option to use boiling water and reduce the time. Anyway, so we've got the feathers harvested up. I was thinking that before we head out, I did want to take the jerrycan with us. How heavy is this? It's really not that heavy. I would like to bring that back possibly to a fishing village or fishing area where we could potentially refill that. It's not going to do a whole lot of good over here. I think I will leave the birch saplings, though. I put some items over here for us to bring so I wouldn't forget them. I better grab them now. Those guys right there. Okay. Now, I was going to leave a note here. Let's change our note about here at the maintenance garage. We are going to get rid of the jerry can because we're going to take that with us. Okay. Take that with us. Oh, did that just cancel it? I probably did. Let's see. Does that work? No, I think it did save it. I think they made an update to that so that it saves now. Okay, well, I think we're ready to head out, guys. Let's get a little bit of a drink. The water situation is 1.52 liters. You know, I'm going to grab one of these. We'll grab one. And then we got some meat in the back here. Let's get down low. See what the weather's like. It's actually not too bad. All right, let's eat up, fill our belly. And I thought today we would head back to Forlorn Muskeg. And I'll tell you about that in a minute. Let me finish eating here. Delicious venison for breakfast. And one more for the road. Okay, we are lightweight. Well, not we're not lightweight. We're not smelly. That's what I meant to say. Now I should, you know, let's go into our little outdoor area. Ooh, the weather's changing. Don't like that. Okay, no wolves. Well, I hope the weather doesn't get too bad. I was actually hoping to travel. But at any rate, let's get a fire started. Well, we'll use our fire striker. Okay, so I did a poll on my channel recently to find out where you guys would like to go next, if we should go to possibly Bleak Inlet, Hushed River Valley, Blackrock, or if we should just go and focus on getting our bearskin bedroll done. And I haven't even looked at the results yet because I couldn't wait to play the game again, honestly. So I just jumped right in. I'm still going to wait till I hear from you guys before we decide. But I figured in the meantime, we pretty much have to head that way anyway. And I would like to check out the cave again in Hushed River Valley. Sorry, in Forlorn Muskeg. That's what I meant to say. I want to go to Forlorn Muskeg and check out the cave. See if we can get some more coal. What am I doing here? I was trying to get some tea. Okay, so this is what happens when I try to talk and do things at the same time. Let's place a tin can here. Yeah, we are super low on coal. I'd like to get our coal replenished. We gotta head that way anyway. So I thought, why not? Let's head over that way. We do have the raw bearskin coat that is in the poacher's camp, and I would like to get that curing. Okay, I'm going to drop some other items here. Let's drop some coffee. I don't know if I actually use it. And we'll drop some more tea. Just get that all warmed up. Okay, I think we're all set otherwise, as far as like torches and things. Yeah, we got a ton of torches. I'm gonna drop some of these. And we'll drop that one too. We got a lot of torches. I do plan to do a lot of walking today. Okay, let's go ahead and drink a reishi tea. I think we're ready to go, right? Hopefully the weather will hold up. And let's head out. A little bit on the heavy side. That's all right. Okay, goodbye, maintenance shed. You've been a wonderful base for us. I've actually had a good time here at the Broken Railroad. It has been pretty good event. A good time, man. Is there really a blizzard coming in right now? You gonna do this? Oh. All right. We can go read a book or something. The game says no. Well, do we need this fire for anything? Don't think we do. I'll light a torch just in case while I'm thinking about it. Let me think. What do we want to do while we're waiting? We do have the daylight. It's really nothing I need to cook. Just kind of a shame that we lost our match, you know. I'm gonna have to light a torch in the future is what I'm thinking, you know, when the blizzard's done. Okay, we are nice and warm here. I could just read a book, I guess. Let's get our book out. Where are we going? We do have the fishing frozen angler book. Got 4 hours remaining. kind of sounded like it was going to lift for just a second there, and then it started up again. So let's read another hour. Oh, and the sun's going down, guys. Oh, man, this game. This game. Although sundown is kind of a good time to travel. So we had to harvest the ptarmigan feathers. That took us to like half the day. And then we have to read to get the storm to pass. Three hours in a row. Big blizzard. All right, down to our last hour. How are we doing for water? Let's get a drink. Well, the good news is we can drop a book when we're done here, get a little bit more lightweight. You know, I can drop this one too. That's just fire material there. Okay, got one more hour. Let's see what happens. You know, I'm gonna cancel. Gonna cancel because I need every minute now. Dang it, I hate to use another match. But it is what it is. Okay, we're gonna... you know, I'm just gonna light the torch. Let's get the torch out. Here we go. I'm just gonna walk with the torch. This has backfired on me before, walking with the torch unlit. But I'm gonna do it. I really hate to use another match.
The sun is setting. It's gonna get a lot colder soon.
Yeah, it's kind of a shame. We didn't get our warming up benefit when we left here, so yeah, I'm gonna have to use a match. As we start to get cold, I'll get a fire going. Warm up some tea. Okay, guess I'll stop and get a fire going over here. Yeah, let's just light it up. Right there. It wants to. There we go.
Come on, little fire.
Okay, let's add some fuel here. Let's drop our teas. And drop a couple coffees. Ooh, those ones are 53. Okay, yeah, I'm hoping when the sun sets, the snow's gonna stop. Let's take a torch. All right, let's head out of here. There we go, guys. That's what I was hoping for. Nice, clear evening. Beautiful sunset. Have I been up here? I don't know if I've searched those. I think I did need to pick up another rock. Yeah, I better pick up another one. Should take two. No, we're good. Two stones is good. Okay. Yeah, I don't think there's really anything to loot there, right? It does look really cool, though. Yeah, I do like trains. Be nice if they had the logo painted on the side, you know? Okay, we got a wolf up ahead. It's our first customer. Be nice if I could get in front of him. No, guess not. All right, come on, wolf. Yeah, I was hoping he would run that way. Okay, the wind is nice. Almost no wind. Best kind of wind. So I think I'll probably walk to the poacher's camp, grab the items, and then walk to the tunnel and drop a bunch of stuff. And then I'll just hug the shoreline and walk around until we get to the cave. I think it's the transition cave that goes to the Bleak Inlet. Although, you know, it is pretty dark, pretty late. I might want to just go through the tunnel and rest at Trapper's Cabin. It might be the best option. Stop and have a look here. We got a waterfall in the distance. So far, no Aurora, which is good. Okay, so I was talking to or chatting with somebody in the comments about possibly making a bearskin coat, a second bearskin coat, or possibly a bearskin bedroll. And the more I think about it, the more I like the idea of having one bearskin coat and one wolf coat, which is what we have right now. Hey, there's a deer. And the reason I think I like what we have now, a couple reasons. I think maintaining two bear coats might be a little expensive, you know, as far as using bears. And we have an abundance of wolf skin, so it should be pretty easy to maintain. And you do get a little bit of extra warmth if you had two bearskin coats, but I don't think it's worth the wait. And, you know, if you have the bearskin on the outside layer, you get the benefit of the wind and attack protection. But I don't think it really double stacks if you have two bearskin coats. It's just the one on the outside that's gonna take the damage, right? And the protection. So, I probably shouldn't have thrown my torch right into the transition zone, huh? That could have been bad. Could have lost my torch there. Okay, so we're now back to Forlorn Muskeg. Weather's holding up pretty good. Pretty well. It is a beautiful evening. You know what we could? Go up to the cave that's up here. Although we did most recently, I think we came through that.
Warming up a bit.
Oh yeah. Did I already lose my warm drinks? I did. I always forget to do that. I always forget the warm drinks. Alright, let's see if we have any sticks available. We could get a fire going. No sticks. Alright, I'm just gonna use one of my sticks here. Let's try, I guess, right here. Okay, let's go ahead and put out my torch. Let's add some fuel. It should be enough just to get our teas warmed up. You know, I'm gonna cook some more. Can drop some tea as well. Then let's go through our torches. Harvest that up. Okay, let's drink up.
Sure, I can carry much more.
Anyway, I would, I'm interested in your comments on that, on the bearskin coats. Do you think it's worth having two bearskin coats? And then I'm also thinking of getting a bearskin bedroll. Hey, got some scrap metal. Eventually, I probably would swap that out for the down feather bedroll. It is lightweight. But I'm thinking of crafting up the bearskin bedroll. I don't think we've been to that Hunter's Blind. Would be kind of a ordeal to get over to it, though, wouldn't it? I'm gonna check my crampons. Let's put these on. It looks so close, guys. So tempting. Although it does look like a problem.
I need to find some place to escape this cold.
We got so many cattails in this area, I forgot about that. We'll leave the cattails for now. I have so many. I am out of sticks, however. Okay, can we make it across here? Looks like we can. Let's drink another tea. Hey, I remembered. What do we have here? Bear kill. I've already been here. No, I haven't. Okay, we've got a candy bar. And a book we can't really use. And that's about it. Let's put a spray paint on here. Low visibility. Okay. Alright, so train tracks, where did you go? Are you over there? That's train tracks. You know, are we close to the cave? You know, I'm just gonna head up here. What you are seeing right now is the story of my run here. The story of my Interloper run is I just get so distracted. Like, oh, look at that. Change of plans. We're going to head over here. But, you know, you can pretty much do whatever you want as long as you have food to eat and you're warm and dry and have water to drink. You can do whatever you want. Okay, I think this is the... Is this where the rope comes down if we had dropped a rope? Might be. Oh, we got a tower up there. Is that the tower? What is this? Ooh, hey. Abandoned camp. Never know. Nice, I didn't even know this was here. Gloves. Okay, got a shelter, snow shelter. Interesting. Oh, we're getting so heavy now. Oh, a little bit of lag there.
Gotta warm up somehow.
Hello, Wolfie. All right, where are you? I'm not gonna shoot him. Oh, I didn't mean to do that, actually. Yeah. That was weird. It's like, I'm like, tell you what, guys. My mouse has been doing really weird things lately. Are you bugging out? He just reset. Wolfie, I don't want to waste the arrow on you. So yeah, that the bow pulled back and released without me releasing the mouse clicker. I wonder if it's time to replace my mouse. Or I wonder if it's related to that lagginess. I don't know. At any rate, I was surprised. I was as surprised as the wolf was when I shot an arrow at him.
It's so cold. I just want to lay down for a bit.
Okay, yes, we are cold. Let's, and heavy. Cold and heavy. And getting heavier every time I pick up a stick. What is this place? What is this? Probably need to make another fire here pretty soon. Like right now. Okay, it's just a little tunnel access. Kind of nice. Interesting. Let's head over here. Warming up has expired. Well, we were not very warm anyway. I really just want to find that cave. All right, let's make some more tea. Hey, Wolfie. Okay, how cold are we? 8 degrees. Let's add some more fuel. Okay, how are we now? 4, 3, 2. Stopped at 2. Come on. Let's add some more fuel. Okay, let's cook some more tea. Nope, that's not tea. It's a nice clear evening here at the Forlorn Muskeg. Okay, how's our torches looking? Astrid. That's a good torch right there. Alright. Let's drink this. Take that. Let's drop some torches. They're actually all pretty good. Just have so many of them. You know, I'm gonna run and then we can sleep in the cave. Oh my goodness. Why do we have so many wolves tonight? I'm so glad we don't have an Aurora, though. That was pretty good. By coming over here, we found that secret camp, hidden camp, with the sardines. And got another pry bar. Okay, I think we can follow this river. And it should take us right up to the cave, if I'm not mistaken.
Starting to feel numb.
We can sleep in the cave, drop a bunch of stuff we don't need, like the pry bar we just picked up. This is a lot steeper than I remember. Okay, so up here is where we got jumped by that wolf once. I remember that. I could drink another tea right now, but we are very close to the cave. I'm not very thirsty either. Okay, the rogue wolf that jumped us was right in those trees last time. So I'm gonna stay away from the trees. Let's just head up here. We'll go through the cave and get as much coal as we can. And there is an argument for going into Mountain Town and grabbing the heavy hammer. That is an option. Okay, we made it. Very nice. All right, I'm gonna drop a bunch of stuff here. First thing, let's sort our weight. Okay, we're gonna drop that. And what else did we pick up? Got like some books and stuff, right? Did we finish this one? No, I canceled it before we were done, right? So hang on to that. Drop that. Drop those. Feels good to be warm again. Can drop our saplings to cure. You know, I'm gonna drop these for now, just to get lightweight. And I'm curious, did it save our game when we came in? I think it did, didn't it? Because I think this is considered an indoor location. So I think when you go inside, I think it does save. Let's try it out again. Saving, yeah, okay, saving the game. Okay, nice guys. I'm going to exit the game here. I'm going to save my video and I'll be right back. Okay, back in business. Now, it's still quite... Ooh, it's about time to go to bed. I was going to say, it's still pretty late. Yes, it is. Okay, time for bed. I guess I'm just going to put out our fire. Put our bedroll down. Is there anything else I need to drop? I think we're good. Got all the stuff curing that we need to drop. Let's get a drink. Ooh, I should probably eat some food. Let's eat some of the, sort by weight. How's our weight? Could eat these potatoes. Yeah, I'm gonna eat a potato. And let's just eat both of them. Alright, I was just watching Zach today. He's playing a challenge where he survives only on things that wash up on the, beachcombing. And I was just wondering, do vegetables and stuff wash up, like potatoes, cookie ingredients? I'm curious if those would show up. Anyway, that was an interesting video. Turns out you actually possibly could survive just on things that wash up on the shore, on Interloper. Okay, let me check our water one last time, get a drink one more time. Torch is going to go out, that is just fine. Alright, I'll see you guys in the morning. Ooh, we even have a little bit of light. That's nice. It'd be nice if I could get a fire started with the sun on the mag lens. Let's see if I can get a fire started.
Man, I could use a drink.
No, we are not going to get a fire started. Okay. Well, we'll get a drink, head inside. Okay, so I'm going to leave these here. We are nice and lightweight again. I'm just going to drop a bunch of stuff here. Well, good enough. I can see okay. I hope you guys can see all right. I'm going to walk through here and possibly go grab the heavy hammer. I would really like to have that heavy hammer over by the broken railroad, you know. When I come back through here, I will use the torch and we will pick up any coal that we see on the way back, if there is any. I hope there is. Hopefully you guys can see okay. It's not a whole lot to see. It looks like a dark cave. You know, and before I saved my game there and restarted, I was thinking about how I pretty much keep myself guessing and what what I'm gonna do. Why am I looking over here? You know, I'll get easily distracted, and you never really know what I'm gonna do. And it reminded me of a book I read by Stephen King. I'm not the biggest Stephen King fan, but he wrote a book about writing, like if you wanted to be an author. The name of his book was On Writing by Stephen King. And I really liked his description of how he writes. You know, he says some authors will think beforehand the entire novel. Like, they'll plan out the entire book. They'll plot it out. But Stephen King's style is he creates characters. Oh, hey, we got another rope. Nice, I might grab that. You know what, do I need that? Do we need that to get back up to the... No, I don't need that. Okay. So what he does is he crafts characters. Like, he perfects the characters kind of like on a stage. So he'll set the stage and then he'll create a character. You know, somebody who's a compulsive liar or somebody who's very greedy or is altruistic. You know, would die for anybody. And he puts them on the stage and just lets them play it out. And he said that because he does that, not only is the audience surprised at what happens, but he's surprised. And you can guarantee if the author is surprised at what the characters do, then the audience isn't going to see it coming. And I really like that. That kind of is my play style. You know, I could plot out. You know, I could say, oh, well, today I'm going to go do this and that. But my character style, you know, I'm kind of scatterbrained and ADHD and who knows what else. So I keep myself guessing. So I'm going to keep you guys guessing, right? Kind of keeps it fresh, I hope. So like right now, I'm looking for birch bark. I didn't plan on looking for birch bark. I was going to climb up the mountain and go get the hammer. which I still will do, but hey, birch bark. Right? Shiny. Look, shiny stuff over here. We have not had birch bark for quite a while. So I am I'm actually happy to grab this birch bark. It's not super cold. It is, you know, it is getting cold, but maybe I can pass some time here until the sun comes out. We can get a torch lit. Okay, birch bark, where are you? Let's hurry and grab our birch bark and get out of here. Pretty sure we've already searched him, and we have, yes, okay. But I'm here for the birch bark. Okay, I just heard a ptarmigan. Where are you, ptarmigan?
I need to find some place to escape this cold.
There's ptarmigans. Nice. Let's go grab those ptarmigans. Be very, very quiet. Oh, really? Are they gonna fly? Oh, come on, you don't have to fly. So are they gonna land again?
I could eat a horse.
I don't know. I lost track of them. All right, let's go get warmed up. I'm gonna eat some food. What do we have here? Eat some cattails. That's a lot of cattails. Okay, we're almost out of water. Okay, I will make a fire right here. Right by this little rabbit. Okay, the other rabbit is gone. Let's get a fire started here. Okay, how cold are we? 10 degrees. 8 degrees. Is it still going down? 7? Do I hear 6? Let's add 7 sticks. Okay, we should be warm now. We should be warm. What's going on here? There we go. Let's harvest this guy up. We'll use our hands. We can warm up. A little rabbit.
So cold, I'm warming up a bit.
Thank you, little rabbit. Where did our rock go? How many rocks do we have? We got one rock, okay. I'll have to pick up another one. Thank you, rabbit. Okay, got 9 minutes there. Let's use our knife. I gotta get some water cooking. We are just about out of water. Get a little bit of a drink. And that's it for our water, guys. We are out. Okay, we are smelly, but there's no predators up here. I think there can be a moose, though. We'll cook up a little bit more water. Let me see what's... check our clothing. Could harvest these up.
would drink almost anything about now.
Okay, let's put on our ear wraps. Oh, we got all the birch bark we could harvest. Oh, I forgot to do that. Alright. Alright, let's get some more birch bark harvested up. Craft it up. We are slowly warming up. Could possibly be a storm coming in. Guess I'll grab one more gut. May as well. So these, those are almost done.
I can carry much more.
Okay, I think we are good to go, guys. Thank you, rabbits. Don't need your hide, but we will take the guts. Hello, sir. You missed out on the feast. Maybe next time. Yeah, it reminds me of the walrus and the otter. You guys remember that from Alice in Wonderland? Okay, I'm gonna drop these guts here. Hopefully back here it can cure. I don't know though. Let's see what happens. Nope. Those are not gonna cure there. Okay, let's get a stone. I want to grab these? Nah, I'll leave them. Okay, where is that climbing wall? Is this it? Yeah, this is it. Okay, I'm going to drop all the smelly stuff right here. There we go. And there we go. Let's climb up. Hear those ptarmigans again. Okay, we have made it to Mountain Town. We just need to sneak over here to the whatever this place is. What is this? The Hermit's shack or Hermit's cabin or something? Grab the heavy hammer and head out. Looks like we do have wolves today. Or is that a deer? We got a deer. I don't see the moose today. Not sure where he's hiding. Okay, this is where I practiced archery before. Really, really terrible at shooting the rabbits. How did I miss these? Did I just not want to take them? I keep hearing ptarmigan sounds, but I don't see them. Did I already check that? I probably did, right? Yeah, I did. Okay. All right, let's grab the heavy hammer. Thank you. I'm going to leave that. We're actually doing pretty good. How's our water situation? 3.69. We're doing good for water. Okay. I'm going to leave all this for future Astrid. And we're off. Okay, so our little shopping trip here to the grocery store. We were able to pick up a bunch of birch bark. We got the rabbit meat. Got our water cooked up again. Of course, we got the heavy hammer, which was the whole reason we came. And got some... What is that called? I keep forgetting the name of the... rose hips. That's right. We got some rose hips and some more mushrooms. So it worked out pretty good. Let's head back to our cave. Looks like just in time. We do have a storm blowing in. And it's getting late. I'll head back to the cave and then I want to try to find some coal. Right. Okay, let's head into the cave. I Okay, this time we actually have a light source.
Surrounded by snow and nothing to drink.
We can get a drink. Somebody was asking why I don't turn off the sound effect of Astrid talking. And she actually helps me a lot. She tells me she's thirsty or hungry. If she didn't tell me, I would forget. Or when she's freezing cold, you know. I would totally forget. Okay, anything good here? That's kind of an interesting little ledge. It's got the rope. First, we had the deer carcass that was here. We harvested him up. And I don't see any coal today. I was really hoping to get some coal. Let's head this way. Coal is such a valuable resource. Hey, we got one piece. I'm gonna backtrack just a little bit. There we go, that was worth it. Okay, we can head back this way now. Yeah, if I don't have, you know, at least 5 pieces of coal, I really feel unprepared. Okay, all in all, not too bad. Okay, looks like my torch is about out. I'm gonna relight my torch, head out, and then back in to save our game. And probably save my video at the same time. See what kind of weather we have. It's probably still pretty snowy. Yeah, time of day. Sun's about to go down. I think we're just going to end up sleeping the night here because of the storm outside. So in that case, do we want to make a fire? Let's see, we do have a bunch of wood. I'll grab these. Let's make a fire. I could read or something for an hour. Okay, let's put this out. You know, I think I am carrying the guts, right? Okay, that's it for the food. All right, let's see. Let's get some water cooking. Okay, I'm gonna see what we can craft up. We do have more birch bark. We could read the book as well. Sounds like our water's done. And that one as well. Ooh, a little bit of glitching there. Okay, I'm gonna try to read. Wait, I thought we had 2 hours left on there. Alright, well, that takes care of that. So we're done with the fire. Should have checked it. Alright, what do we have? Water boiled. Let's pick that up. Let's take some charcoal. 2 pieces. And we'll go ahead and get our bed ready here. Nope. Right here by the guts. We'll put our feet down at that end. Let's put our lantern out. Let's get a drink. And sleep for 10 hours. I'll see you guys in the morning. You know what? I probably won't even make it to 10 hours. We weren't really all that tired. Yeah, still pretty late. We are fully rested. Let's pick up our bedroll. I wouldn't mind having a look outside. Let's see if we have stars or a storm. We've got a storm. Very cold. Let's check the temperature. Negative 15. Well, air temperature is negative 39. And because of our clothing, feels like negative 15. All right. Okay, so now, question is, what are we going to do? Let's see what I can do in the dark. Okay, that's it for crafting. Now I'm curious about the acorn grounds. Oh, we gotta cook the acorns. Oh, wow, okay. I never really paid attention. Ooh, we need the heavy hammer too. Hey, okay. Acorn grounds. Ground acorns makes a wholesome but very weak cup of coffee. And I wonder if that gives you, it probably gives you a little bit of nutrients, I would imagine. Probably not a whole lot of calories. Bearskin bedroll. Now this one's gonna take about 23 hours. If we can get our we need two cured black bear hides. And I looked at my notes and we have, of course we have the black bear hide back at the camp office. Let's look at our notes here. Okay, so we have at Kwanzaa Garage, we did have one, where is it? Bear meat, coal, water, heavy hammer, quality tools. Bear hide, there we go. So we do have one bear hide at the Kwanzaa Garage. And then in Pleasant Valley, by the abandoned prepper's cache, we do have one bear hide. And then I think we have one at the camp office. No, we took it to Trapper's, didn't we? Trapper's cabin. I think we did. I think we put the bear hide in Trapper's cabin, if I remember. In the locker or something. Yeah, I think we did. I just didn't leave it here. Okay, so we do have, if we go round up the bear hides, we could make it work. Let's see, do we have any clothing we could harvest up? We got those gloves, right? We already harvested the gloves. Okay, I might just have to pass time, guys. It's still pretty late. Let's pass some time here. Okay, sun is up now. Ooh, I didn't get a drink. There we go. Sun is up now. Did I finish the book? I did. Okay, so we could drop that. Let's get our lantern lit. Okay, I'm going to pick up our things. Don't need that. Too heavy to carry. Okay, I'm gonna leave the guts here curing.
Okay. Starving.
Let's put this out, check our food situation. Let's eat some of these. Do we want to save the carrot and the maple syrup for cooking? That is the question. Alright, let's check our other items, see if we want to drop anything. I could drop this here. It's nice to be back up to 7 coal. Man, we got a lot of stims. 5 stims. And we got some back at the... Got some back at the camp office, I think, as well. 6 liters. Ooh, let's drop some of that. Drop 4 liters. I think we're doing okay now. Drop these. And I'll hang on to the rest. Okay. Let's go check the weather. Ooh. Wow. I was not expecting that. Super windy and cold, but very beautiful. No chance of having a torch lit out here. So beautiful. Look at the purples and blues and oranges. Just amazing. There is a chance on sunrise. There's a chance you could get a fire started with the mag lens. No. Okay. Not light enough yet, but oh my goodness, that looks amazing. Of course, we do have the wolf in the territory. I don't want to attract the wolf, but I do want to peek around here just to see the beauty. All right. Guys, I think this is a great place to call it an episode, Sunrise. And want to, of course, say thank you for coming along with me. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, let me know. Leave a comment. Thumbs up is always welcome. I do appreciate it. And I hope you'll come along with me in the next episode as we continue our adventure. Until then, this is Sprocket saying thanks for coming along, and I do hope to catch you in the next episode. Take care.
Thank you.